Yes.
How are you getting along?
Fine, Mr. President. Wonderful, thank you very much. How are you?
I'm fine. Are you getting any rest this hot summer?
No, we're not, because we have racial problems here, and I spend about 24 hours a day among them, and that's the only way to keep them quiet. I get insulted, but I don't let them insult me. We just keep on moving.
Goodness. What percentage of Baltimore is Negro?
60% in our schools and 40% whites in the schools, 60% Negroes, and the opposite is just in the 60% whites and 40% Negro population. But they're concentrated, you see, all around the core of the city. We're building a beautiful city in right here in the business area, but all around us we have bad conditions.
Could I talk to you on something very personal to me and that's in the strictest of confidence?
Yes, indeed.
I don't want anybody to know it but me and you. I just might have to urge you to come over here and help run Washington for it.
Well, I'd like to think about it for a benefit, too.
But we have 60% Negroes. We also ought to have some young, able, attractive Negro in the administration. We under this new reorganization, I told him I was going to get the best man in America to run the city. I rather think that I'm going to have to ask you to do that, and I would like to take a young, able, some fellow that could stand some training that was a Negro and put him in as an assistant and let you try to train him to see how it worked out, see if he could ever take the thing over when you got to where you felt up to it. But I'm just afraid I'm going to have to ask it, and it's a lot better assignment than Vietnam, although it's not a very good one.
Yes, could I think it over and talk with some people here?
That should give you old fringe benefits, or you could go out on a boat, take some people now and then, and try to ease some tensions and the sports and things of that kind. What's your salary over there?
$25,000.
Well, you get about the same here. Get $28,500. I know you don't like the thought of undertaking a heavy thing and a new thing, but I just think the next year or so you just got to do this. I think we got to draft you. I don't think you got any choice.
I have to talk over this naturally with my wife.
I think we ought to have a Negro somewhere in the chain of command, and I think he could carry out your instructions. He could carry out your instructions. He could carry out your instructions.
All right. I'll call you.
If you don't, I'm going to send you the name.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. President. I'll call you. Bye.
I became the first chief executive black in the nation. I became the first housing director black in the nation. I joined John Lindsay's cabinet when I fell out with President Johnson, went to New York as chairman of the Housing Authority, the biggest in the nation. I became the first African-American leader of mayors in this country. I served with five presidents side by side. Johnson, of course, was the best. I sort of struck the line that I felt that I could take comfortably, meaningfully, helpfully, and I went on from there. There was not a committee that was appointed from Washington or from this region that I was not appointed to. I went back to Washington and started my service from there as the first African-American to sit as the executive in this country. Now, Renee, I don't care what anybody said. I had some people who didn't like what I was doing.
Why didn't they like it?
They thought I was a little too nice. Thought I should be harder, tougher. My job, I thought, was to get something done for the people of the city. I embarked to do that. I tried hard to do that, and I came very near doing it.
But some people felt at the time that you weren't militant enough.
That's right. That, I mean, he's a nice guy, well met. People like to shake his hand, people like to say hello. But he's not up to it.